is Darren Hartley, and I am an addict. I was born in Toronto, 1984, April 2nd, but I was brought to Windsor when I was 2 years old with my mom. Growing up with a single mother, you know, the party life just seemed to be the cool thing to do. Being a kid, they don't seem to show you the downside of it. Thinking your whole life it's the cool thing to do, you kind of have no other choice but to dabble in it and try for yourself. And that's the problem right there. Once you started trying, and it moves on to the next, and I'm a full-blown addict. I've been sober now almost 10 years. November 4th will be 10 years. When they say there's three things, death, institutions, or prison, they're not kidding. Been to prison, already died once, and then this was my second time nearly dying. Right there, that scar. That was my message from God to say, smarten up. And watching my little kids climb on the floor, I knew I had to find a new outlet. So I thought being addicted to money was the thing. And that right there, yeah, money's good and all if you use it the right way, but gaining it and having a bunch of it and getting addicted to it, you start doing the wrong things. And I ended up doing my time, 19 months, in a maximum prison. It wasn't fun, it was hard. But what made me stay good in there was before I went to prison, I had good people around me telling me that's not the place to go. I was about 95 to 105 pounds. I have a before and after picture on my Instagram. I was soaking wet, 102, 105. And there's gonna be some pretty big scary guys in there that would take advantage of me. So I was suggested maybe start working out. So I did. And I literally started with a 10 pound bar and worked myself up from there. And as I was growing, I started getting attention. And it wasn't that negative attention that I was used to. It was positive attention. It was pats on the back. It was, hey, I'm willing to help you now because we see you're trying to help yourself. What you really have to do is try and truly try. Don't fucking fake it and pull the wool over their face because they will see through it. And if you do, you'll be surprised at the people that will come out to help you. Once I started growing more and more, I was introduced to maybe you should throw some, you know, posing trunks on and go on stage. Just fuck that. I'm not doing that. I'm not putting those trunks on, doing anything like that. But what it did was gave me a sense of where I'm going with fitness, because I didn't just want to be a meathead walking the sidewalks. I didn't want to be that person. That's not the person I truly am. So when I did step on that stage, it just opened up the whole new world of like, oh, I can do better. I don't want to place last. I don't want to feel like this. I could do better. So now I have a goal in mind. I remember when I was going to prison, I went with my family. We went out and I was supposed to be getting sentenced a couple nights out. We went out for the night and got home pretty late. And there was a message on my phone from my mother, stating she needed to talk to me. It was kind of important. So please call me, right? So I'm like, I'll call her in the morning. She just lives a few blocks down. Oh, you know, I'm tired. Well, by the time that morning called and I went to go see her, she was already gone. She was dead on the couch. And honestly, you know, we tried everything, called the ambulance. We tried to bring her back. They got her organs back, but she was completely brain dead. And it was like, fuck, what do I do? Do I go relapse? Do I go do this? And I almost did, and I did for a little bit. Not with heroin or nothing. It was crystal meth, but it wasn't for long. It was a quick, you know, a couple weeks. What are you doing? Get out of this and pull your shit together. Instead of quitting, I continued to do that first competition because that was months before I competed. I could do better, I could break this chain. So I did. I had a purpose. So I continued to bodybuild because that was the only way I knew how to show others, because you can't just be 100 pounds and go show someone else that's 100 pounds. Hey, I was an addict, I've been sober 9.5 years. You really look it, bud. You know what I mean? I compete for the Canadian Physique Alliance. I compete this year on October 8th in Toronto, Ontario, and then October 1st is the first one, which is in Burlington, which is Legends Cup. Never gave up. I have placed, top 10 My first year, top five. My second year, second place. My third year, top eighth last year. I am now coached by one of the best coaches I have ever had, Johnny Shreve. I'm sponsored from some of the best people like Chad Burnell from TNT Waterproofing and Concrete, Boma and Associates, Kai Kai's Cookies and Ice Cream, CCBD for me, and Dominion Contracting, Ferocious Barbershop on Tecumseh Road. He helps me out a lot with my hair, making me look all fresh and good for a stage day. If you don't chase your dreams, you'll never catch them. I'm Darren Hartley, thank you so much. I'm gonna go hit the gym, guys, because that's what I do. We got a competition coming up, so number one for Windsor.